Hi, friends, and welcome inside Club 71 here at Dana J. Dykhouse Stadium for Game Day Eve. This place will be rocking tomorrow, as will the stadium itself, as South Dakota State, number 3 in the country, looks to get back to its winning ways against the Sycamores of Indiana State. Of course, the Jackrabbits are coming off what was a classic in the Fargo Dome on Saturday, a back-and-forth affair between two of the top three teams in the country. The Jackrabbits fall 21-17 to the Bison. Isaac Wallace ran 9 times for 110 yards, including that 61-yard go-ahead touchdown run in the third quarter. What a day for Adam Anderson up in Fargo. 8 receptions for 102, his first back-to-back string of 100-yard games for the wide receiver. So now the Jackrabbits look forward to tomorrow with Taryn Christian on the precipice of a school record. He stands just 91 yards away from passing Austin Sumner for the most yards ever thrown by a quarterback in SDSU history. He also sits 374 yards shy of the Missouri Valley Football Conference's career total offense record. Isn't it somewhat ironic that Christian may indeed break two huge records on Hall of Fame weekend, where he'll no doubt end up one day here at South Dakota State? It is not only Hall of Fame game, it is also the inaugural Precision Ag Bowl, as we honor not only the agricultural tie-ins between South Dakota State University and this great state of South Dakota, but also the brand new technology of precision agriculture. Now, the opposition tomorrow is the Indiana State Sycamores. This is a team the Jacks have not played the last 2 years under second-year head coach Kurt Mallory, in a much different spot than they were the last time the Jacks saw them. Earlier this year, they beat Quincy to open the year. That snapped a 14-game losing skid. Didn't win a game last year. Then, a couple of weeks ago, they put 55 points up in a win at Eastern Illinois. First Division I win in their last 15 tries. So, it's a program that is turning things around. To give you an idea of the difference in the Sycamores between last year and this year, they've already scored 90 points in 4 games. They had 111 total a year ago. Last year, they turned the ball over 29 times in 4 games, only 2 turnovers. Now, they are coming off a disappointment, a 33-0 loss at home to Northern Iowa to open the year, of which they never really were able to do much offensively against the Panthers. Had a couple of opportunities, some trips inside UNI territory that didn't pan out. Panthers were very good in that particular game. They've used 2 different quarterbacks. Jaleel Kilpatrick started the year, went down with a shoulder injury early in game 2. It's been Ryan Boyle since. Boyle actually began his career at the University of Iowa, a very decorated recruit, but this is a team that wants to run the football. How much so? In their 4 games to this point, they have run the ball on 77% of their snaps. That is the 8th most in the country. The other 7 that have run the ball that much or more for percentage of snaps are all option teams, where that is really what they do. Now, some of that's been because of weather at Louisville with all the rain, but this is a team that wants to grind it out. Jaquan Keyes is the leading ground gainer to that point. 83 rushes, 492 yards on the ground, and 6 touchdowns. He's top 10 in the nation in both rushing yards per game and rushing scores. And they've had a couple of offensive linemen who they've switched their numbers to 40, so they'll look like they're lined up with multiple tight ends, but sometimes they're just offensive linemen. They really do want to control the game on the ground. We flip to the defensive side of the ball. Much like SDSU, the strength of the Sycamore defense is at linebacker. Catrell Moss, a 5th-year senior out of Indianapolis, leads the team with 37 tackles. One back of him with 36 is Jonas Griffith, a 4th-year junior out of Louisville. The defense has allowed 42% on third down this year. They have struggled at times trying to get off the field. Even in that win at Eastern Illinois where they put up 55, they allowed 41. So the Jacks will no doubt try to exploit some things defensively for Indiana State. One other thing to keep an eye on is they are very good in the return game. Dakota Caton, a long of 49 with an average of 24 yards per return. He can be electric in that part of the game. So SDSU hosting Indiana State, final night game of the regular year for the yellow and blue. So if you're coming out tomorrow night, bring a jacket. We do have some tickets available at jackrabbittickets.com or 1-866-GO-JAX. You can also purchase them here at the ticket office, here in the box office throughout Dana Dana J. Dykhouse Stadium at the various ticket booth locations. If you can't be there in person, radio coverage. Mike Strzok makes his return on Hall of Fame weekend as Strzokapalooza 2018 takes center stage. He'll be joined by Scotty Quaz and myself starting at 5 o'clock throughout the Jackrabbit Sports Network. ESPN Plus and Midco Sportsnet have the television side of things with Tom and Hank and Elena as well. It's the inaugural Precision Ag Bowl. It's Hall of Fame weekend as number 3 South Dakota State hosts the Sycamores of Indiana State. Kickoff at 6 o'clock tomorrow night under the lights at beautiful Dana J. Dykhouse Stadium.